हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर रोटेशनल डायनामिक्स. फ्रॉम दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड सर्कुलर मोशन एंड फ्रॉम द लास्ट टू वीडियोज वी स्टार्टेड द रोटेशनल मोशन. इन दिस टू वीडियोज वी लर्न द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ रोटेटिंग बॉडी. वी लर्न द फॉर्मूली ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, ऑल्सो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. And in the last video, we obtained the expression for the angular momentum of rotating rigid body. Now today we have to obtain the expression for the torque acting on the rotating rigid body. Before that, let us revise within 2 minutes whatever we learned in the previous videos. See, you know the formula for the moment of inertia, I. Please say along with me, I is equal to summation of I goes from 1 to n. m r square suffixes I we have to give. That means I is equal to m r square. M is the mass of the body and the r is the not body but the m are the masses of the different particles and r represent the perpendicular distances from the axis of rotation. You know that. Okay, also we obtained the expression for the kinetic energy, that is e rotational is equal to 1/2, do you remember, 1/2 I omega square. Also we obtained the expression for the angular momentum in terms of moment of inertia. I is equal to I omega, L is equal to I omega. Okay, so we learn these three formulae. Now suppose this is the rigid body, it is rotating about this axis of rotation with the angular velocity omega. This axis of rotation is passing through the point O. This rigid body is made up of the large number of the particles, n number of the particles. Okay, now suppose these are the particles. So you know that whenever this whole body is rotating about this axis of rotation, these particles perform the circular motion. That means this particle is performing the, suppose this particle is performing the circular motion, that means it is moving along the circumference of the circle. I explained the previous two videos. Okay, let us revise within the 2 minutes. Now this body, this particle is also performing the linear motion because it is moving. Suppose we had considered the small part of that circle, it is the straight line. That means it performs the linear motion also, and that linear velocity we are showing with this. Okay, so in this case, see the concept again. I am repeating so many times the concept, very important concept, that whenever the any body performs the rotational motion, its different particles perform the circular motion with the different radii, and their centers lie along this axis of rotation. You know that. And this particle is performing the circular motion, at that time it is having the linear velocity, suppose v. So this linear velocity and this angular velocity are related with the relation, you know that v is equal to r omega. That means linear velocity, angular velocity are related with the r. Also while obtaining the angular momentum of rotating rigid body, we consider the relation between the linear momentum and angular momentum as, do you remember that? That relation is the L is equal to Rp. Okay, L is equal to Rp. L is the angular momentum and P is the linear momentum. See how they are related. Now also you should know that whenever this body is having this angular velocity omega, it is having the angular acceleration alpha. Okay, so here also the linear acceleration will be there because linear velocity is there. So this acceleration, linear acceleration and this angular acceleration are related with this relation A is equal to R alpha. In the 11th standard we obtained that relation while learning the circular motion. Okay, so A is the linear acceleration, alpha is the angular acceleration, very important. See how these relations are there, linear velocity, linear momentum, linear acceleration. Also you know that whenever the any body performs a linear motion, why it is performing the linear motion, why it is moving along the line, because of force acting on that. okay? So because of the force the linear motion produces, so that F, okay? And in the case of the rotational motion, you know that there is a couple of force. Because of the couple of the forces the rotational motion produces, that means the torque is acting on that body. So the force is related with the torque. How they that relation also we learn in the 11th standard. That relation is the tau is equal to Rf. See, all these quantities are related with the R. Okay, so tau is equal to Rf. This very important relation we are going to use to obtain the expression for the torque in the case of the rotating rigid body. Okay, so see, V is equal to R omega, linear velocity, angular velocity, linear momentum, angular momentum, linear acceleration, angular acceleration, force because of which the linear motion produces, and torque, that is a couple of the force that is that produces the rotational motion. So in this way, all these relations are very important. You must know this one. Also, in the case of the rotation, in the case of the linear motion, force is given by you know that important relation, F is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay, A is the acceleration, M is the mass. So all these basic relations you must know while obtaining the expression for the torque acting on the rotating rigid body. Okay, so let us start that expression for, you can write along with me, expression for, and please note down these all relations. Aap pause karke, video pause karke, you can write these relations. Okay, expression for torque, that is tau, it is denoted with the tau, on rotating rigid body, on rotating rigid body. Okay, now whatever the figures we drawn in the case of the kinetic energy, in the case of the angular momentum, same figure we have to draw here also. Consider the rigid body. Okay, suppose it is rotating about this axis of rotation, which is passing through the point O. Suppose angular velocity is the omega and the angular acceleration is the alpha. Okay, it is rotating with the angular acceleration alpha. Now suppose these are the particles, same figure we have to draw. Consider the particles having the masses m1, m2 up to mn, because this rigid body is made up of the large number of the particles. Okay, so nth particle is having the mass mn. Okay, so 1, 2, n you have to write as the suffixes. Let us consider these particles are situated at a distances r1, r2 and the rn. These are the perpendicular distances of these particles from the axis of rotation. These particles are performing the circular motion, so let us show these circles. Okay, part of the circle. In the case of the kinetic energy, whenever we draw this figure, kinetic energy formula is 1/2 mv square. V is there, so we had shown the linear velocity tangential. In the case of the angular momentum, L is equal to rp, so we had shown the p here. Do you remember? Okay, so in the case of the torque, since we need this relation, tau is equal to Rf, this tangential forces acting on the particles we will show. Let us consider the F1 is the tangential force acting on this first particle, F2 is the tangential force acting on the second particle, Fn be the tangential force acting on the nth particle. Okay. So whenever you can, whenever you are writing the explanation, once you have drawn this figure, you can write the explanation. Same sentences you have to write, whatever you had written in the case of the expression for the kinetic energy, expression for the angular momentum. And third time we are going to write the explanation of this figure. Let us consider the rigid body, which is made up of the n number of the particles, which is rotating about the axis of rotation passing through the point O. Okay, consider the rigid body rotating about this axis of rotation passing through the point O. Let m1, m2 up to mn are the particles situated at a distances r1, r2 up to rn respectively. Okay, after that you can write, let f1, f2 up to fn be the forces acting on the particles, on the particles which are performing the circular motion. Now suppose, and here also we have to consider the alpha, as I mentioned about it, alpha and the omega. that this body is rotating with the constant angular acceleration alpha. What is this? Constant angular acceleration alpha. That acceleration is the same for each particle. Okay, it is not different, but linear acceleration will be different. Here A1, here A2, here A3. So you can mention that A1, A2 up to AN be the linear accelerations, linear acceleration of different particles. Of the different particles. See how we can write the explanation. We have to obtain the expression for the torque. So what are the related quantities with this? T is equal to RF. F is the mass into acceleration. So we had written about the A1, A2 up to AN, that are the linear acceleration of the different particles. Okay. Now let us consider tau1, tau1, tau2, tau3 up to tau n be the torques acting on the different particles. On different particles. Okay. Now, by definition, this tau is given by vector r cross vector f. Similarly, we had written in the case of the angular momentum. Do you remember that? Vector L is equal to vector r cross vector p. Okay, here f, r cross f. Okay, this can be written as in magnitude, tau is equal to rf sine of theta. Now here, see, this is the r, this is f. So angle between them is 90 degree. So theta will be 90 degree. So sine 90 will be 1. Therefore, tau is equal to rf. Okay. So by using this, we can write tau1 as r1 f1. F you should write here small. Okay. R1 F1. Again, F, you know that F is nothing but the mass into acceleration. So for the first particle, F1 will be MA. So give the suffixes 1, because for the first particle we are writing. This tau is a torque acting on the first particle. Now here again we can write R1 M1. Now this A is nothing but the R alpha. Okay, that linear acceleration and the angular acceleration are related with the A is equal to R alpha. So for the first particle, A is the R1 alpha. So R1 square, it will become R1 square, and the alpha is the constant. Don't write alpha 1. In the case of the angular momentum, don't write omega 1, omega 2. Okay, similarly here also we have to write the constant angular acceleration alpha. Okay, similarly we can write for the tau2. How? This is for the second particle. Now tau is the RF for the second particles, that's why I give the suffix 2. Similarly R2. Now F is the mass into acceleration. F, that is the ma, force is the ma. So F2, so give the suffixes 2. Okay, similarly R2 M2 as it is, and A is the acceleration, that will be R alpha, but that will be R2 alpha. So R2 again, so it will become R2 square and alpha. In this way, for the tau n also we can write Rn Fn, which is equal to Rn. F is the mass into acceleration, give the suffixes n, which is equal to Rn Mn as it is. A is the R alpha, so that will be Rn square and the alpha. Write down this equation as a number 1. Equation number 1. Okay, this is the equation number 1. Now, addition of all these tau1 will give the total torque acting on the rotating rigid body. So we can write tau is equal to tau1 plus tau2 plus tau3 plus, in this way, up to tau n. Okay. Now tau1 means these last terms we have to add now. Okay. So if you will observe these terms properly, then see alpha is common there. And these terms are nothing but the R1 square M, that means MR square, MR square, MR square. So we can take alpha common and add we can rewrite this R1 square M1. Instead of that, we will write the M1 R1 square plus M2 R2 square plus Mn Rn square and alpha. Alpha is the constant. Now, this term is nothing but, what is that? Moment of inertia. Okay, that is nothing but Mr square. See, Mr square, Mr square, Mr square. So, Mr square, and give the suffix says I. So, I goes from 1 to n. So, I is equal to 1 to n, and that is alpha. Okay, and you know that this is nothing but the moment of inertia. So, I alpha. So, we obtained the expression for the torque in terms of the moment of inertia, and this is the required expression. See how simply we obtained this equation. Only you have to remember this link. What is this link? F is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration is nothing but the R alpha, and tau is equal to RF. Okay, so in this way, by using this formulae, this basic formulae, we can obtain the expression for the torque acting on the rotating rigid body. Do the practice of this derivation. Go through the pages from the PDF. Copy down those pages in your notebook. Listen this video and write down it without referring the video or without referring the pages. Definitely you will understand. Okay, thank you students.